A car crashes into a house, and a little later, a car slams into a building on the other side of the state line. We have two very crazy stories for you tonight. We begin in Belton with a pair of women, both lucky they are at home instead of in the hospital. KMBC 9's Robb Yagmin is live near Belton High School with a unique story. Robb?
A very unique beginning, a thankful ending. It started right here in this parking spot and ended, as you said, inside the house.
Springtime in Belton. The blooms, the birds, the beautiful sights were replaced this evening with the sweet sound of 3-inch screws into 3/4-inch plywood.
It came in about 5 feet.
It was a 2-door compact car masked as something else.
It seemed like an armored truck, though.
Yes, it did.
Just before 5, as a lady was on this couch, a friend pulled up out front to check in, hitting the gas instead of the brake.
I came down here expecting a bump in the wall, and we had a car through the wall.
The car did tear through the duplex wall, shattering glass and splintering wood, and ending up only 36 inches from the couch.
She was sleeping, and it woke her up, of course, scared her to death.
In the end, police helped the driver out and pulled the car out of the wall. As for the renter on the couch, she might have had some help, too.
She's a very... This little gal is just very faithful.
Now, best news tonight, neither one of the women were hurt. I talked to the lady who lives inside. I talked to her son tonight. He said she's staying with him. As for the car, when the police actually pulled it out of the house tonight, only a couple of scratches. Driver drove it home. As for the house itself here, insurance agent's going to come by tomorrow and kind of give the duplex owner where to go from here.